So how do we know if we need to update our firmware? Let's ask Wes at the bench. Hey, Wes, I have a question du jour for you.
All right.
How do we identify procedures for updating firmware? I mean, how do we know it needs to be updated? Are there any symptoms?
No, none.
Okay, thank you, Wes. I'm going to go now.
A very short episode, right? Probably not what you were thinking. No, when it comes to, you know, a lot of the things that we talk about through this series, you know, they do so manifest in sometimes some type of symptom. But BIOS being out of date really doesn't manifest itself anyway. It's just one of those things that, you know, as a, you know, maybe a technician or maybe it could be a home user, that we kind of got to just, you know, absorb it, take it under our wing, and just know that it's something that we have to do.
And well, what about causality? I mean, is there something that we can check to see if it's outdated or it needs to be updated?
Well, there's a couple things. Let's touch on the first point there. You said a cause. Really, with the cause, this really isn't anything anybody's doing wrong. It's not anything that the manufacturer's doing, and certainly not the end user's fault by any means. It just means that you've got a motherboard. As time progresses, vendors find things that they have, functionality flaws, maybe even adding additional features that they want to do it. And they don't go to every single person, you know, if they make 100,000 of these motherboards, they don't go to every single person and update it themselves. It's just something that we have to assume that responsibility for. So when we talk about cause, it could be the fact that the motherboard that you buy, it could be on the shelf for a while. If you buy your computer from, you know, any place that sells computers, it could be on the, it could be on their display floor or in a box, you know, back in their warehouse for a while. Mm-hmm. And as time goes, as you know, computers, fast as computing really does move, the technology wise, you just get behind the times. That's all. So nothing really big on that. Cause just means that, hey, as computers progress, they, a lot of times that they're going to have these updates to the firmware platforms.
So where do we go then to find out if it does need to be updated?
Well, that's a great question there, Zach. There's a couple of different places that we can go. You can boot right into your BIOS, just pushing a certain keyboard shortcut. Mm-hmm. Pay attention to your vendor's instructions and how to do that, because it can vary slightly between different vendors. Mm-hmm. Or you can go into the operating system. I like to go into the operating system because if I think I have to do a BIOS upgrade, then I can check what the firmware is. Mm-hmm. I have the web browser right there. I can go to the vendor's website, mm-hmm. verify it. If I need to, download it, format a thumb drive where we put these files and just reboot, you know. So I like to start in the operating system.
Well, can you give us an example of how that looks?
Sure, let's take a look here. Okay. So we're in our Windows 10 machine here, and there's a couple of different places that you can do this. One of the main places I like to go is to a little utility called MS Info.
Right.
You'll see that it's a system information application comes up here. And if we launch this, there's a couple of things that we're looking for. One of the things I'm looking for, two of the things, honestly, I'm looking for is the system model, the name of the motherboard, mm-hmm. And then what the current firmware is, because I need the vendor, and I kind of need this information. I know it's a little hard to see, so what we're going to do, what do you say we make it a little easier, especially for somebody like me who has glasses. I'm going to open a notepad, show you a cool little trick here. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy the system manufacturer, because I have to know, well, who is it that makes it, mm-hmm. And we'll just kind of paste this into our notepad there, so you can see it a little bit easier, makes it a little easier to see. Mm-hmm. And then what I want is I want this line, because that's the motherboard itself. Mm-hmm. All right, because I have to go to the manufacturer's website, and I'll just paste that. I can see it's a Z390 gaming export. Mm-hmm. But then what's really super important in the end here is this. Notice it says BIOS, and it says version and date. And again, let's copy and paste this into something, makes it a little bit easier to see. All right, so now we've done a little bit of our preliminary detective work,
We got
our Columbo hat on. We got Gigabyte is the manufacturer. The system model, the motherboard is Z390. And then finally, American Megatrends or AMI. This is the version of the BIOS here. And I can see that the version here is F8, which right now at this point means absolutely nothing to me.
Correct.
Because the version numbers are going to be, their naming conventions are different.
You don't know what version it is.
Yeah. Yeah. And then the other thing that we can see right here is the fact that we also have our date. And you can see that this date is actually, we're in August of 2020. Ooh. You can see this date is about a year old.
So we might be maybe a version or two behind me.
Yeah, that's a good observation. Yeah, given the fact that it's been about a year since we're seeing this version here, mm-hmm. my guess is that there's probably at least one.
Okay.
Be more, but at least one version that we need to kind of upgrade onto. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to take this information. We can close the system information tool down. I'm going to leave this notepad up, and what we'll do is we'll fire up our web browser, and we're going to go to Gigabyte's website, and again, because that's the manufacturer, and we're going to look for inside of their inventory, if you will. We're going to look for our Z390 gaming export, and do pay attention because there are minor revisions of these boards, which essentially is a different hardware platform. And this one is revision one. I know this because I built this computer. All right. And what we want is the support page. Now, the support page, you'll see that it defaults to what the operating system is that we're using, and we're using Windows 10 64-bit, and that these are the various drivers that you might need to update, but one, the driver, or specifically, that we want is really the firmware platform, and you can see BIOS here.
BIOS, right.
And if I expand that out, you remember that if we compare this information now, that it said that we have F8, and it showed that date, we can kind of see here, if I get this out of the way, that F8 is right there. All right, and I can at least see that there's an F9, but scrolling up, I can see that there's also an F10.
So we're two versions
behind. We're two versions behind. Right. So what we need to do is we need to just click the download option here, and I'm going to go ahead, and what I'll do is I'm going to save this. You could save it to your downloads folder. I like to just know where my downloads are going. I'd lose my head if it wouldn't attach. So I'm going to save it right to the desktop, just to make it easier for our viewers to see. And then at this point here, I'm going to close down our web browser, and we've got the firmware that we need. And in fact, I'll go ahead and close down our notepad here, and we'll just go ahead, and we don't need to save any of that. And then at this point, what we're going to do is we're going to right-click, and we're going to extract this folder, all the files. I'm sure, I assume there's another directory here. Yeah. And then here are the files that we need to make sure that we can flash this firmware platform. Now, the next thing that we have to do, Zach, is we have a USB device that is in here, and you can see it's right here, and what we need to do is we need to prepare this USB device in order to put the BIOS firmware, new firmware on it.
Do we have to use a USB to put the BIOS on
it? Yes, okay. Yes. You want to use a USB thumb drive, plug it into the, anywhere on the PC. That's typically the way that you do it, and then you reboot the computer, and provided you have it formatted right, the BIOS should recognize it. Let me show you something here that I've run into before. This, if you look, if I go to format, this particular USB device, you're going to see that the capacity is 20 gigs. It needs to be no bigger than a 2 gig part, or I should say, it can't be bigger. Your files themselves, they need to be a certain size. If the drive is too large, then you can't. Windows won't give you the ability to format in FAT32.
Okay.
And specifically, that's because FAT32. You want FAT32 because of the fact that it is recognized typically by all of your vendors out there, because it's been around for a long time. It's been around since the 80s. So that's why we want to make sure that it's FAT32. So if you needed to do that, easy way to do this is disk management. We could go up to disk management here. And originally, if I just go ahead and delete this volume here, let me show you what I mean. And so notice that this is a 60 gig thumb drive, right?
Okay.
FAT32 is not going to work that well. And if I just do a new simple volume here and I start clicking next through this wizard, giving it a volume label, and if I look at the down option, notice it says NTFS and XFAT.
Yes.
And that's because of the limitations of FAT32. So before I do this, what I need to do is I need to kind of go back to the beginning of the drive here, and rather than just doing a simple volume and letting Windows format the entire drive, I'm going to reduce the size of this drive a little bit and hopefully give us the ability to see FAT32 come up in the list. I'm going to format it down to about 20 gigs, about a third of the size of what this drive actually is. I don't care what the drive letter is, that's perfectly fine. And now if I hit the drop down list, you'll see FAT32 is in the list. And again, it's just because I couldn't use the entire volume. And I'm gonna call this firmware. And the reason I'm doing that is because sometimes when you get into your BIOS, it'll just recognize a crazy string that you don't know, you can't really identify if it's a hard drive or not. This lets me know that when I look in the BIOS, if I see something called firmware, then that's going to be the drive I'm looking for.
And naming convention you can understand and remember.
Exactly. And it's really for identification purposes. I could call it paper, rock, scissors if it fits, and it doesn't matter, but that really probably wouldn't do me too much. So we'll go ahead, and if we look here, we'll just choose finish. It's going to format that drive in FAT32. You'll see that Windows is telling us we've got a new drive here. It mm-hmm. is formatted, and what we're going to do is just take this little folder that we extracted, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to just put this right there on that thumb drive, and now we're really ready to go ahead and restart this machine, and when we restart the machine, we'll get into the BIOS interface. And keep in mind, when you restart your machine, you're mm-hmm. just pushing a certain keyboard combination mm-hmm. When you see the splash screen, and that'll take you into your BIOS where you can do the flashing of the firmware.
So can you take us through that?
Absolutely, let's check it out. So we've restarted Zach here, mm-hmm. and what we've done is I've hit that F12 key for this vendor. Again, pay attention to whatever the vendor is to get into this screen here. And kind of a side note, you'll notice that it says Patriot Memory here, partition one. I kind of know that. You might not recognize it right away, but that's our actual thumb drive that we put in there. And we're gonna go ahead and choose Enter Setup, and what that's gonna do is that's gonna take us into our BIOS interface. And again, pay attention to the settings that come along with the motherboard, you know, and the instruction manual in order to do this. Mm-hmm. What we're looking for is actually QFlash. Mm-hmm. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna select QFlash, and you'll notice that we've got, well, two different options here.
Right.
So we have Update BIOS, but we also have Save BIOS. Now, what I'm gonna do before I make any modifications, and by the way, too, as a side note, remember that I told you could see in BIOS what the version, the date was?
There it is.
That's the same information that's being reported to the operating system. Mm-hmm. What I'm gonna do first, though, is I'm actually gonna save the BIOS.
And that's like a backup.
It is. You wanna make sure that you back up those settings mm-hmm. just in case something goes wrong, mm-hmm. if the flashing process, if you will, fails, mm-hmm. you can then restore from the earlier settings.
And with the flashing process, what is that exactly?
That is just really what they call writing to the ROM chip that's on the motherboard, the BIOS ROM chip, or UEFI ROM chip. So let's take a look here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select this part, this drive here. Notice that it says we've already got BIOS that we need to use. But mm-hmm. I'm going to go ahead. And I'll just call this backup BIOS, and we'll just, from there, we'll just go ahead and choose the right arrow in this case, and what it's gonna do is it's gonna write those instructions that are currently in the BIOS to that thumb drive.
See, that was fast.
Yeah, it doesn't take long, all right? And we'll just go ahead and escape out of this, go back to QFlash, and now at this point, what we're gonna do is we're gonna update the BIOS. So we'll select Update BIOS, and I have to select the folder. And when you select the folder, again, this is why it's important to remember what the folder name was. Mm-hmm. And then you can see this Z390GX10C.
Yes.
That 10C is telling us what the same version that we've seen.
Yeah.
That's right, that we've seen on the mother or on the vendor's website. Mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and choose that. And then what we're going to do is choose to, you know, what do we want to do? Do we want to do an intact or do we want to do a fast update? In this case, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do the intact update. Now, this could take a while. This might actually not be too long, but what we can see here is now what's happening is it's overwriting the instruction set that was prior, the one that we backed up. So essentially what it's doing is it's overriding the old BIOS ROM instructions or UEFI ROM instructions with the new instructions. Mm-hmm. And if anything should go wrong, it'll let us know that it'll reverse that process, it'll back out, and then at that point, what I'd wanna do is I'd wanna reflash the ROM, again, write those instructions via this interface for the old settings, and then start the process again.
Now, I noticed you went right to the 10 and skipping the 90s. You don't need the 90s.
I don't need
and
that's another
current version.
I'm glad you mentioned that, absolutely, because what happens is when they make those changes, they usually roll up the last changes into the new version. So essentially, 8 was in 9, and then 9 was rolled up into 10. Mm. So we should have all of that functionality ready to go, and even correcting any of the functionality that maybe 9 didn't give us. So you'll have that and then some. So if we take a look here, we can kind of see the process that it's gonna want us to reboot the screen or reboot the machine. So Zach, what do you say what we'll do is we'll go ahead, we're gonna reboot this machine. When we get done rebooting the machine, we'll look into BIOS one more time.
Oh, good.
And then, in fact, we can do it right here. Let me go ahead and let's show you here rather than having to get into the operating system. We can do this right from BIOS here mm-hmm. in general. And you'll see me hitting the F12 button rapidly.
You don't have anything against that.
No, I don't. Notice it says the boot menu here. That's gonna take us back into that boot menu. And look, the whole screen's color. Color has changed.
Yeah.
And then when I said that it gives you improved functionality sometimes, we choose to enter the setup now. Mm-hmm. check out what it looks like now. Look at the interface, how it's changed, right?
It has.
And we can see right here, Zach, that we have the same motherboard. That didn't change. The BIOS version is F10C. That's right. And we've got an entirely new, pretty BIOS interface, I have to say here.
I like it.
Now, one of the things I'll have to do right away is I notice it's in French. I don't speak French. I wish I could. That's right. So I'm going to change the default language here to English, and then we can save our changes. But there you go, Zach. That, in a nutshell, is how you identify that your BIOS is out of date, where you can go to find that information, how you can acquire the new firmware code, and then finally how you can apply it to your system.
Thank you, Wes. I knew we could count on you.